much. My name is Shuhei Nakamura from Osaka University. So first of all, I'd like to thank this EuroAccess Japan and the staff member for giving me this opportunity. So I'd like to talk about how to maximize your chance to get the Marie Curie Fellowship. But before that, I'd like to introduce myself. So I got a PhD at Hokkaido University in 2008. And then I moved to the National Institute for Basic Biology in Japan. And then I did the first postdoc. Then I moved to Germany as a second postdoc. Then I did the second postdoc job at Max Planck Institute for Biologic Aging. So during that time, I was supported by JSPS Fellowship and also the Marie Curie International Incoming Fellowship. And from this April, I got a position at the Osaka University. My research field is biological science and medical science. I'm interested in the molecular biology of aging and also the autophagy. So as I said, I was supported by a Marie Curie International Incoming Fellowship. At that time, it was within the framework program 7. And the period was 2 years. And then host institute was, as I said, Max Planck Institute for Biological Aging, which located at Kulm, Germany. And my supervisor was Professor Dr. Adam Antebi. And my project name was the germline-mediated regulation of lifespan in worm and fish. So as you already heard, application itself is composed of two parts, part A and part B. And part A is basically your personal information and more administrative part. And part B is actual scientific proposal. And this is my the table of content of my proposal. And as you might see, that in my case, it's almost 30 pages. So it's really long, unfortunately. So it takes very long time to prepare this proposal. And then I heard that normally to be funded, you need to get more than 19 score. So of course it depends on the budget, but minimum you need to get 90 scores. And then this is the current version of the table of content, part B. And also the some parts are slightly different, but overall, structure itself is similar. So you need to get a high score, therefore you cannot ignore each section. And actually each section will be equally evaluated from the referee. So because of the time limitation, I cannot go into the detail, but I will show you some something that I think is important in part B. So of course, you need to describe the realistic proposal, including a backup plan with Gantt chart. And you also need to show that your ability and your host institute ability, capacity. And you also need to think about your strengths and unique point. And you need to mention what you can bring into EU host country. I think that's something as they expect. And you also need to think about your career, future career plan itself. Then you also need to emphasize how beneficial is this Marie Curie Fellowship is to your future career. And if your research has potential to lead to the long-term relationship between EU and your original country, like Japan, even after the project, I think it's better to mention it, because this is also the one of the purpose of this fellowship. So actually, I still have. So even after I come back from Germany, I still have some strong relationship between current Osaka University and also the Max Planck Institute of Biology. So one thing I want to also emphasize in part B is the following things you need to repeatedly claim in a whole part B. So this is something different from other grants, for example, JSPS or Cuban frontier and Embo. Normally, they try to avoid the repeatedness. But in this case, I think it's better to repeatedly claim this point. These are more general tips to maximize your chance to get fellowship. So first, I recommend to get successful and if possible fair application together with the proposal evaluation form. So when you submit your proposal, you get such kind of evaluation form. The good things for this evaluation form is briefly mention about your strength point and also weakness. So from this, you can learn about what they expect in each section. So this is very informative. And of course, you also need to closely communicate with your host institute. Otherwise, you cannot get specific information from your host institute. And so Marie-Curie fellowship call is open on March, and deadline is September. It's 6 months, but I still suggest to start drafting as early as possible because it's very long. So again, I want to also emphasize how important this natural contact point, because they are really give you the more personalized feedback. So you can search this specific national contact, nearest contact point from this website. In my case, I use the national contact point at Bonn. So they are really helpful. They can check my personal personal proposal. And they are really helpful for me. So if you are interested in my proposal or evaluation form, please contact me, or we can also discuss later. So this is a picture that when I went to the Paris and when I went to the Marie Curie's graves. So actually, after I submit, next day I went to the Paris, then I went to Marie Curie's graves and prayed for success. In my case, it works.